こんにちは、エリカです。Hi, this is Erica and we're going to be studying for the JLPT. So today we're going to do lesson number 15. And here we will do 手置きます or 手置く。So please look at the first page of your textbook. So, as I said before, today we're going to do a verb plus 手置きます、手置く。So when do we use this? It says here on the bottom, 将来のための準備。So we use 手置きます when we want to talk about preparation for the future. For example,please look at number one.
テストのために消しゴムを入れておきます。
So, テストのために for the upcoming test. For the test,
消しゴム this is eraser. 消しゴムを入れておきます。
I will put an eraser into my bag.Or I will keep an eraser into my bag. So, 入れておきます。This is preparation for the future test. Okay, this is one way to use 手置きます。The second way we use 手置きます or 手置く is leaving it as it is. So, it says on your textbook, そのままにする。So, when we want to say something like,Please leave it as it is. For example, number two.
そこに置いておいてください。
Okay. 置いておきます becomes 置いておいてください。
置いておきます。そこに置いておきます。
So here, they are talking about a pen. Before 置いておいてください, they said, Shall I take the pen with me?
ペンを持っていきましょうか?
Shall I take this pen with me? And a person answers, そこに置いておいてください。 Now, please leave it there. Okay? Leave it as it is. 置いて is place. We're going to talk about this later. But, 置いて is place, and 置いて is place it there and keep it as it is.So, let's look at some examples. Please go to the next page. These are sentences using 手置きます or 手置く。So, please look at number one.
来月は入学式なのでスーツを買っておきます。
Okay. So, next month,
来月は入学式。I have an entrance ceremony.
So, I will buy a suit.
買います。買っておきます。
買います。This is a verb. Okay, to buy. So, this example is talking about the preparation for the future. This is number one.
Okay, 将来のための準備。
So,
スーツを買っておきます
means I will buy a suit.For the future, for the entrance ceremony. Number two. Sentence number two.
これから忙しくなるから今晩ご飯を食べておくね。
食べておくね。So, from now on, I will be busy.
これから忙しくなる。
So, I will eat dinner now.Okay, 今晩ご飯を食べておく。 So here again, they are talking about preparation for the future because
これから忙しくなる。
They will be busy, so to prepare, they will eat dinner now. Okay, 食べます is a verb to eat.
食べます、手置く、食べておきます。
Okay.So number three. Number three says,
試験に合格するために
漢字を全部覚えておこう。Okay. 試験に合格するために。To pass the exam, 漢字を全部覚えておこう。Let's memorize. 覚えておこう。Let's memorize all the kanji. So again, this is number one. Preparation for the future. They are preparing for an exam. 試験に合格するために。To pass the exam preparation. Memorize all the kanji. 覚えておきます。Okay. Now please go to the next page. Let's look at sentence number four.Sentence number four says,
先生、ドアを閉めた方がいいですか?
Okay, this is a question. Teacher or Miss なんとか、Mr. なんとか、Should I close the door? Okay,
ドアを閉めた方がいいですか?
And number five. Number five, the teacher answers,
いいえ、そのまま開けておいてください。開けておきます。開けておいて、開けておいてください。
So they're saying no, please leave it open. Leave it as it is. So number five, the meaning is number two, leaving it as it is. そのままにしておきます。Okay. Please leave it open. 開けて is a verb.
開けておいてください。
Leave it open. And finally, number six. Number six says,
林さんは疲れているので寝かせておきませんか?
Okay. So, 林さんは疲れているので because Mr. Hayashi is tired.
寝かせて
Okay. 寝かす To sleep. Keep asleep. 寝かせておきませんか?So, will you let him sleep? So, in this situation, Mr. Hayashi is asleep.
Hayashi-san は寝ています.
Okay. So, he is tired.
寝ているので、leave him as he is.
Okay. そのままにしておきませんか? 寝かせて
おきませんか?
Again, this meaning is number two, leaving as it is. そのままにしておく。Okay, let him sleep. So, now let's go to the word section.
言葉2の
1. So, I am going to pronounce some vocabulary. Please repeat after me and check the meaning and pronunciation. Number one.Number one is そのまま。そのまま。As it is. そのまま。Number two.
放っておきます。
放っておきます。This means to leave. Okay. 放っておく。To leave something as it is. Leave. Next word.
寝かせます。
寝かせます。This means put to bed.Okay.
寝かせておきます
to let him sleep.
寝かせます is put to bed.
Next word,
起こします。
起こします。This means to wake up. Okay, wake up.
起こします。
Next word,
部活。
部活。This is club activities. Okay. Next word,
Uniform.
Uniform. Okay. This is uniform. Next word.
T-shirt. T-shirt.
This means T-shirt. Next word. Polo shirt.
Polo shirt.
This means polo shirt. Next word.
短パン
短パンThis means short pants. Okay, 短パン Probably up to your knees. 短パン Next word.
ジャージ。ジャージ。
This means jersey. Okay, or sports jacket, maybe. ジャージ。Next word. スウェット。スウェット。This means sweatshirt. スウェット。Next word. 靴下。靴下。This means socks. Next word. スニーカー。スニーカー。This means sneaker. Next word. お礼に。お礼に。This means in appreciation. So, お礼にプレゼントを渡します。In appreciation, I will give you a present. Next word. お詫びに。お詫びに。This means in apology. Okay. お詫びに。仕事を します。Okay? An apology. Next word. ついでに。ついでに。This means in passing. So, ついでにやっておきますよ。I will do this, along with my regular work. ついでにやっておきます。Next word. それなら。それなら。This means then. So, this is the end of the lesson. Thank you for listening, and please review your grammar and check your answers for the listening and writing section, and I'll see you next time. Bye!